Asia?
Eso, shall we? So, good afternoon to everyone present here. Thank you to each every one of you for being here with us today. I'm very pleased to welcome you all. So now let's begin the session with a prayer song. I call upon Dr. R. Kumuda, Professor and Head of Department of Civil Engineering, to deliver the welcome speech.
Dear President, good afternoon to you all. So, on behalf of Department of Civil Engineering, I am very happy to welcome you all for this inaugural function of our Civil Engineering Association. So, as far as our Civil Engineering Association is concerned, so we have a well-structured association. So with office bearers holding different portfolios with a lot of responsibilities. So we have the president, and then we have treasurer, then we have general secretary, joint secretary, and also the executive members. So as office bearers in our civil engineering association. So the department was started long back, so in the year 2008. So since then, so we are having this association, and we are doing a lot of programs through the Civil Engineering Association, so for the benefit of the students' community. And also, I'm very much happy that so in the last year, this is 2021, so we were able to prepare our department magazine. So I'm happy that so this in this particular program or in inaugural function. So we are going to release the first magazine of our department, the Civilian Chronicle, so for the year 2021. And I hope in the last year also we had done a lot of activities through our engineering association, and which includes some international seminars also. So in that way we are progressing ahead in all the students' activities. So I wish to continue this in future also. So with this note, so I am very happy indeed. It is a great honor for me to welcome the chief guest of today's inaugural program, so Dr. Sai Babu, so who is the managing director of Polucare Engineers India Private Limited. So in fact, Dr. Sai Babu has a vast experience in this field, particularly in the field of environmental engineering. And also, he's an expert in the project management. So he has vast international exposure also, and he has a very strong linkage with the government in terms of providing some solutions for the environmental issues. And he is a very successful entrepreneur, and he has developed his company. Lot of passion, and so I feel definitely it is a great honor for us to have Dr. Sai Babu with us today to inaugurate the Civil Engineering Association. So in fact, we're connected long back, but due to a certain so since we were in online mode of teaching, we were not able to invite him for a program. So I've used this opportunity to invite him for inaugurating our Civil Engineering Association, and he has readily accepted for that also. And so I'm on behalf of everyone present here, so I extend my cordial welcome to Dr. S. Sai Babu for this inaugural program. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. So as I have mentioned in the beginning, we are doing a lot of activities through this association, and we have the faculty coordinators, Mr. R. Kalaivanan, Assistant Professor of Civil Engineering, and also we have Mr. S. Harishwaran, Assistant Professor of Civil Engineering of our department. So they are taking care of this association activities. So I welcome the faculty coordinators for this program. And also, so we have the faculty members here. We have a good team of faculty members. We have both 12 faculty members in the department, specialized in various domains. So I welcome all the faculty members for this program. And also I welcome all the office bearers who is going to take charge for the academic year 21-22. And also I welcome all the students of the civil engineering department for this inaugural program. So from this year, I think second year students are also going to take the responsibility as office bearers for this academic year 21-22. So they have a lot of responsibilities with them. And so they have to fulfill their commitment, fulfill their responsibilities with a lot of commitment. And they have to work a lot for the development of this association, and they have to take this forward. So I wish this association great success in the coming years. So with this brief note, I conclude my welcome address. So thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. So now I call upon Mr. R. Kalaivanan, Assistant Professor in Department of Civil Engineering, to introduce the chief guest.
Thank you, Arshia. I'm highly elated to introduce a guest of the day. So Dr. S. Sai Babu is the Chairman and Managing Director of Polycare Engineers. He was born and brought up in rural area, and his parents were school teachers. Due to they have faced a lot of challenges, yet he has completed his engineering degree. Afterwards, he landed in the metropolitan city of Chennai in a desperate situation of survival, and started to climb the ladders in the corporate field. At the age of 40, he established his own venture, basically a successful corporate professional. Then he turned into a first generation entrepreneur. And sir has a vast experience in the field of environmental engineering and international exposure in the project management. And sir established the organization of Polycare Engineers India Private Limited with a resourceful team of skilled personnel with hands-on international exposure. And Polycare Engineers India Private Limited has an extensive client base and has been playing an evident role in the field of environment, sustainable and social development. With a great passion for quality and technology, with a strong networking in government, has been providing consulting, reaction and solution for environmental pollution control at affordable costs, and is involved in nation building activities through recycling, reuse of wastewater, curbing one of the critical issues in the country, especially South India. And having extensive exposure in international project management, sir and his team have successfully taken up infrastructure development projects with various industrial clients on EPC contract basis. And with an extensive experience and knowledge in the field, sir and his team have successfully designed and installed and also commissioned a number of treatment plants like sewage treatment plant, ETP, WPP, desalination plant, and reverse osmosis plant, and evaporation system, and of course, a complete ZLD systems for various industrial sectors and infrastructure development in South India. He has completed state-of-art NEBL accredited, DST accredited environmental laboratory. And Dr. S. Sai Babu is an accredited environmental impact assessment person, and serves function area and expert for water pollution and controlled by QCI NEPET. And also sir heading a team of experts in various functional areas, and sir demonstrated expertise in carrying out the EIA in industrial infrastructure development sectors, and also conducted various environmental impact assessment studies and obtained government clearance from different states as well as from MOEF Delhi. And I would like to, last but not the least, I'd like to mention a few points about the SERS company also here. The Polycare Engineers India Private Limited is a one-stop solution for all environmental pollution control measures for various industrial and infrastructure development and municipal corporation projects in India. And Polycare has been rated as top 10 environmental consultants in India for the year 2019 and 2020 consequently. So a division of Polycare Engineers has one of the premier laboratories with world-class facilities, which is based in Chennai. It was accredited by NABL, that is the National Accreditation Board for Testing and Calibration Laboratories. And Polycare has the employee strength of about 500 people. They're having operations on pan-India basis, and they have operations in Bangladesh as well. Thanks for the opportunity and welcome you, sir. What do you share?
Now I invite the chief guest to address the gathering.
Good afternoon. I am Dr. Sai Babu. Would you be able to hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So thank you. So once again, good afternoon to everybody. I think Professor Kalaivanan has taken the introductory session as well as little bit of inaugural address. Good that he has elaborately given the introduction about me, about my company. Thank you very much. Professor Dr. Kumuda for inviting me to such a wonderful function for such a wonderful college and especially to such a wonderful Department of Civil Engineering. And thank you, Professor Kalaivanan, for the elaborate introduction of myself and about my company. Basically, I would like to introduce quickly about myself, then we'll go to the subject. Basically, I am a mechanical engineer. As Professor Kalaivanan has explained, I was from a rural background from the southern part of Tamil Nadu. He explained, my parents were teachers, school teachers. So I moved to Coimbatore for doing my engineering. I am basically a mechanical engineer, 88 to 92. I done my mechanical engineering, one of the decent colleges in Coimbatore. And I was working for different corporate companies. And parallelly, I have completed my MBA also. Subsequently, I completed my MBA also in another premier institute. So after doing BE MBA, I was working for various corporate companies, multinationals. And in a very short span, because I have not brought even a single pie to Chennai, so I was forced to stand on my own legs. So it has forced me to work hard with the total commitment. And this is how I established myself in Chennai. And very quickly, I have become the CEO of a French multinational company, which we were doing around 300 crores turnover. And I was a frequent traveler to various countries in the world, especially to Europe in those days. And through this company, I was staying in Italy for 6-7 months for certain projects. So I was completely exposed to the entire world, in the business, in the culture, in language, in everything. But I was having my own regret. Why we have not studied civil engineering? Why I have chosen mechanical? So finally, I decided to shift myself from mechanical to civil engineering. So after becoming a good CEO or director of a company, it's very difficult to move to civil engineering again. So I explored the opportunities, and finally they said there is a beautiful department in civil engineering called the environmental engineering. As you are aware, environmental engineering is always attached to civil engineering. It is coming under the banner of civil department, worldwide, especially in India also. So I shifted myself from mechanical background to civil background by studying ME Environmental Engineering in a very old engineering university in Tamil Nadu, in Chennai. And subsequently, I have done my doctorate in environmental management also. So now I have become a complete civil engineer. I think that's the reason SVCE has explored various options and finally they selected me as a chief guest. So thank you very much for that. I'm the person who has converted from mechanical to civil engineering in my career. So this is about my background. And as he rightly said, so finally after doing my doctorate and my ME Environmental Engineering, after moving to civil engineering department, I decided to start the entrepreneurship. Nobody in my family was doing entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship means they will run away. But as you are aware, civil engineering is always entrepreneurship. Every department in any of the engineering colleges, they get the placement. But civil engineers, they will give the placement for hundreds of people. That's a specialty of the civil engineer. So I decided to start my own company. This company was started 10 years back. And of course, a lot of ups and downs. As you are aware, civil engineering itself is a lot of ups and downs. If you see the graph, it will be always ups and downs. In the initial days, we struggled a lot. We started with only one person as my employee in a small single bedroom apartment. And the days have gone. Currently, we have employed around 500 people. We operate on Pan India as well as in Bangladesh. And in 2025, another 5 years down the line, we have a clear-cut plan to employ 2,500 people in our organization. So that's the specialty of civil engineering. I would like to tell the real story about this. I done my engineering. I completed my engineering in the year 1992 from Coimbatore. After 25 years, we went for the Silver Jubilee. I was the organizer. I was always a leader in my college. Of course, I was the backbencher and I was a leader for any initiative, any activities. So I initiated this 25th year Silver Jubilee in Coimbatore. So some years, few years back, we conducted the Silver Jubilee. The budget was 20 lakhs rupees. So initially I thought I will get the help from the electronics. We were having only three departments in our college in those days: electronics and communication, mechanical engineering, and civil engineering. Civil engineering is always the least wanted degree by every individual. People go for electronics and communication, first preference, second preference mechanical, and third preference, and the last preference is civil. So after 25 years also, I thought, okay, the first preferred guys, the electronics and communication, many people were in abroad, India, I thought they will give more money, these 20 lakhs, this particular department itself will give. We generally have all the departments together, we conduct a Silver Jubilee function generally in our college. So I approached all the electronics and communication engineers. Little bit of very, very little response. I was so surprised. Why? These people got the placement when we were doing final year exams, when we are doing only final year writing exams. These guys have got the placement, and why they are not paying? Why they are not giving back? So very little response. Mechanical engineers, okay. Then I approached another big people, mechanical engineers. They are the second most preferred people in those days. Even today. So I approached them, of course, my classmates. Again, not much of response. And the last department left out is civil engineering. I thought I cannot even collect even 2 lakhs rupees, my budget is 20 lakhs because only civil engineering is left out. Only 2 lakhs rupees have been paid by this mechanical engineers, the sponsors. I'm talking about the sponsors, mechanical engineers and electronic and communication. So I was thinking that how come this remaining 18 lakhs rupees, how these poor civil engineers will pay? I was so worried. I approached my friends in civil engineering. I approached the civil department. I'm telling you, friends, it's a big surprise. They paid all the 20 lakhs. I collected 22 lakhs against a budget of 20 lakhs. 20 lakhs have been paid by the civil engineering department alone for the Silver Jubilee function wherein I have studied my engineering in Coimbatore. I'm talking about the reality, it's not a story. It's a reality, it's a testimony. Because most of the people are thinking that, most of the parents are thinking that civil engineers are not getting the placement as soon as they complete the engineering. That's a wrong thinking, wrong attitude. But the days goes by, civil engineers will become the entrepreneurs. Especially in India, it is happening. And civil engineers are giving the employment and the jobs for the hundreds of people. They employ electronics and communication engineers. They employ computer science engineers. They employ mechanical engineers also. But in the college, they have been considered as the least preferred people. So I'm telling you, civil engineers, my dear fellow civil engineers and civil department professors, I'm telling you, you are in the right place. And at the same time, SVCE is considered to be the top 50 colleges in India. And I know your NIR ranking, your NAC ranking, everything I am following. So it is considered to be the top 50 engineering colleges in India. And I am sure the civil engineering is the most preferred, it should be the most preferred department in any of the engineering colleges. That is my suggestion and opinion. Because India is growing at the GDP level of 7%. I'm telling you the fact also. All other countries, European countries, including United States, they are growing at the level of 1%. Japan is growing at the level of -3, -4. And France is again -2. But only in India, we grow at the level of 7% GDP. When the country is growing at the level of 7% GDP, it's the place of opportunities. It's a heaven in the earth. So India is the heaven in the earth. It's a population, young population, infrastructure development, developing nation. All these things put together, we are touching the GDP of 7%. But infrastructure development is going at the level of 2%, 2.5%. Infrastructure development is relating to civil engineering. So what I am trying to say is, this 2.5% of infrastructure development GDP growth has to match with the 7% of the Indian GDP growth. So for matching the filling the gap between the 2.5% of infrastructure development growth in India and the Indian overall GDP growth is 7%, you need civil engineers. In future is going to be the civil engineers. All this computer science engineer will go and settle in the US. Civil engineers are going to rule India. You are going to build the nation. You are going to build the infrastructure. You are going to build the bridges. You are going to build the roads. You are going to build the environment. You are going to bring the, you are going to give the best environment. Of course, the environment is also going, environmental engineering also coming under you. And you are going to build the nation. You are going to build India. So stay back in India and make India much richer than any other country in the world, which you are going to do it. And I'm telling you, friends, for civil engineering, whether you have come to the civil engineering voluntarily or because of your marks or because of your parents or because of something else, if for some other inabilities, don't worry. Civil engineering is the best department to start an entrepreneurship. You will give the job for millions and millions of people around the world. And India is the best place for the civil engineers. And this is my conclusion. This is my conclusion. This is my experience. This is my testimony. And I'm also giving an opportunity for the crowd to ask any questions. You can stop me in between. I can ask any questions. Probably, Dr. Kumuda, can we have some kind of questions from the crowd in case of any questions from about the civil engineering or from the entrepreneurship or about the environment? Any questions, I am ready to answer. We have another 10 minutes to complete my time schedule.
Yes, definitely we can have. So now the
even professors also, if you have anything, you can ask me.
So, sir, I have a doubt. So, how did you start your career as an entrepreneur? Where it began, actually?
The entrepreneurship starts from the bottom of the belly. It will come to the heart. It will come to the mind. Then it has to be executed. I told you I'm the backbencher in my college. Leader. Organizer. The day one onwards, I want to be the entrepreneur, but because of the family situation, because of the parents' compulsion, because of the various commitments in the life, I was working for nearly 17 years. And finally, I decided I need to go with my mind, with my subconscious mind. So that's how the entrepreneurship has been started from my side. And for doing the entrepreneurship, you need to have a lot of courage. Very, very important. Somebody asked Mukesh Ambani, who is the richest person in the world, richest person in India. 4 lakh crores, yes, Indian rupees. 4 lakh crores, yes, that's it. Somebody asked me, because of your father is a great businessman, you are doing this much. Otherwise, you would not have done this. He said, and somebody asked him also, what is the secret? Is it your father is the secret or something else? He said, of course, I respect my father, Thirumbai Ambani, who is the founder of the Reliance. But at the same time, without I have the courage to take this kingdom to the next level, I would not have achieved this much, he said. And I am telling you now also, you should have the courage. The disruption has to take place. I was working for a CEO, full of money, good salaries, traveling worldwide. Every month you travel to Europe. You always sleep in the airports, in the flights, enjoying life. But one fine day, I decided to disrupt my life. Of course, the family members have helped a lot. It's very important. Without the support of the family members, you cannot achieve. Of course, family members supported. One fine day, I disrupted myself and decided I will come to the road, I will come to the platform, and I will start my business. And this is how the entrepreneurship began. Hope I answered your question.
Yes, sir. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm expecting more questions because you are all young people. I told you all the civil engineers are going to become the entrepreneurs. And the title itself, today's title itself is civil engineering and entrepreneurship. You are going to give the jobs for your own batch fellow meets in the mechanical, computer science and electronics and communication. You are going to give in another 10 years down the line. Yes. if you have some.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. This is Abhishek from final year, sir.
Okay.
So my question is that you were stating that there are many opportunities in infrastructure field and in our civil field.
Yes.
So, and still, why is there an unemployment in our sectors?
Unemployment because your own team is killing yourself. Civil engineers, now what's happening in India? People who have completed or who people who are working for masons, people who are working for civil labors, they are becoming the contractor. You engineers do not have the courage. You means you and me both, I am talking about you and me. The courage what mason has got, the courage what the civil labor has got, which the civil engineers, you and me, do not have. That is the reason you and me are not having the job. The jobs are going to the masons, small level civil laborers, and small level civil supervisors. You think about it, in Chennai, how many builders were there? Do you think all these builders were completed engineering, civil engineering? No. Because the civil engineers are giving up to others. You are giving your own opportunities and your own jobs to other people. And other people are taking over. And this is the right time for the civil engineers to stand on your own leg. Be brave. Be courageous on your field. Be confident. Have a faith on yourself. And obviously, the job will come to you. You will give the job for millions of people. Abhishek, am I answered the question?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good.
I would like to add one more point, to the question raised by Mr. Abhishek Murali. So apart from entrepreneur, I was discussing with Dr. S. Kalirajan. So he is the deputy dean of L&T Institute of Project Management. And so when I was discussing with him yesterday regarding the opportunities for civil engineers, he said even L&T today, so they need some 1,500 engineers. Of course, they are not recruiting some fresh engineers as of now, but they need some qualified engineers, at least with 2 years of experience. The only thing what he was mentioning is that the civil engineers, after their completion of the degree, they are entering a company, but they should stay there at least for 2 years. And they should gain some knowledge or experience through their 2 years of experience in a particular company. But nowadays, the young civil engineers, they don't have the patience at all, because as soon as they enter a company, they face some difficulties in their job. So immediately they wanted to switch on to the next company. So that is the problem we have now. So he said, so if they gain some experience, 2 years of solid experience in the company, definitely, so a lot of openings are there for civil engineers as a lot of infrastructure projects are coming up. And they have to be qualified and they need to develop, of course, some skills in order to suit the needs of the company. So this was the comment given by him. So just I would like to inform this in this forum. So thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
And most of the civil engineers also nowadays, they are looking for the white collar job. They want to sit in the air conditioning room. And many of the people prefer to move towards the computer science. Computer science, anybody can do. Even BL, English literature, can study computer science, they can move to software. So civil engineers stay with the core sector, and it will be a blue collar job. Don't worry. But after some time, in the second part of your life, it will be a white collar job. Initially, you need to stay in the company. You need to understand whatever may be the pressure from the boss, from the field, from everywhere. You need to stay back. You need to understand. And you need to understand the complete business cycle of any organization. Then only you will gain experience. So 15 years, you need to be very keep quiet, or 10 years or 15 years. After that, you're going to be on your own. That's very important. That is the reason civil engineers, so I never agree that civil engineers do not have the opportunity. You have plenty of opportunities. Even in the government, you have the plenty of opportunities. In the private sector also, you have the plenty of opportunities. But the salary at which you are getting is very small. It is very difficult for the marriage proposals. Don't worry about it. Stay back. stay back, and your salary will certainly get increased in the 3 years time or 4 years time, 5 years time, once you prove yourself and establish yourself and establish to the management that without you the company will not run. You need to bring to that level, then only you will go to the greater heights.
Yeah, he was mentioning that so in L&T especially they have a high speed rail project, so for which they need about 1500 engineers.
Yes.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Yes, sir. This is Kalaivanan.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So, first of all, thanks for the motivating speech, sir. Okay. And my question is, especially the waste management in India is becoming like becoming a bigger problem nowadays. You know, like so. Or for India, is it a long way to go, like manage all this waste? Though we are taking a lot of measures, like the government is taking a lot of measures. But we're still lagging in the waste management, especially even if you're taking the example for example, Chennai itself. We are managing this, like the waste managers become a bigger problem, whether it is solid waste management and all that. So what's your view on that, sir?
As a company, we Polycare deal with water pollution, air pollution, and the solid waste management, because the environmental deals with these three sectors, and we have expertise in all the three fields. We are into all the three fields, and as you rightly said, it's a big challenge, because water pollution is going to be the biggest challenge. Because for example, if you take Tamil Nadu, it's a water scarcity state. We are fighting with Karnataka for Kaveri water. We are fighting with Kerala for Periyar River. We are fighting with Andhra for Krishna. Of course, we are not fighting with the Bay of Bengal. Otherwise, we are fighting with all the directions. It is all pertaining to water pollution and water depletion. Every day the water is getting depleted because we do not have the proper water conservation methodology, and there is no self-discipline among ourselves, and because of that water depletion is happening and water pollution is happening, and water pollution is going to be the biggest challenge. Another 5 years, you can write a note now itself, another 5 years down the line, Chennai people are going to drink the sewage treated water another 5 years. Because in Singapore model, the Singaporeans, 30% of the drinking water in Singapore is sewage treated water. They are mixing the sewage treated water in the regular treated water and giving it to all the households. It is drinkable. It is not the sin. It is drinkable. And we are also having a technology. We are bringing the sewage treated water within the norms. Currently, we are sending the sewage treated water for the bathing. And another 5 years, the government itself will put the norms to use it for drinking, use it for kitchen. And second biggest challenge is solid waste management. Solid waste management, you do not have the solution. Everywhere plastics, everywhere solid waste, everywhere cloths, everywhere. There is no solution. Now only government of India and Tamil Nadu government has executed a lot of projects on the solid waste. We are also playing a major role in the solid waste management of government, especially work with Greater Chennai Corporation. We work with the Vellore Municipal Corporation and a couple of other corporations, and we work with Assam, Guwahati Corporation. We work with Odisha also for monitoring the processing centers of solid waste management. We are the monitoring agency for various corporations in India, because solid waste is getting processed, reused and recycled, and this is how the government is bringing. So because you cannot dump the how many tons you can dump the solid waste, Perugudu, you are dumping. Pallikarana, you are dumping. Kodugu, you are dumping. Madhavaram, you are dumping. Ambattur, you are dumping. How many places you can dump the solid waste? So, government has executed, implemented processing centers, segregation centers, and the processing centers. There are different processes. You might be aware, pyrolysis process for the plastic, and garden waste is crushed and it is converted as a manure, and the construction debris is again crushed and it is used for the cement plant, and the bio mining, all the dump yards, we are doing the bio mining everywhere in Tamil Nadu. So all these things are government initiative. We are also part of it. And as Mr. Kalaivanan said, this is going to be this water pollution and solid waste management is going to be the biggest challenge. And there is, as an engineer, as a civil engineer, as an environmental engineer, there is a big, big opportunity in the field. Big, big employment, big opportunities in this field. And another 30 years, especially, I'm very sorry to say, we do not have the self-discipline. Very, very sorry. And because of that, the pollution is happening. We should have the discipline to control the pollution. Otherwise, there is no never-ending story for this water pollution and solid waste management. Of course, air pollution is also another big challenge. So, as a civil engineer, you have a very, very high opportunities in this country, in the civil as well as in the environmental side. Thank you, Mr. Kalaivanan.
Thank you, sir.
So, anything we can, any other question? Last question. Otherwise, I'll close it because I'll need to hand over to the next civilian. Yeah, introduction of office place. I need to go. So, are we done with the questions or is there any other question? Last question.
So I think there are no questions.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you for inviting me for such a wonderful event. I'm so privileged and proud to be a chief guest for such a renowned engineering college, especially a renowned department called Civil Engineering Department. Thank you, Professor Dr. Kumuda and all other professors, the management of SVCE, for inviting me and giving me this opportunity. I look forward, as a company, we will look forward to work with you for various aspects in the days to come. Thank you very much. Over to Master of Ceremony.
Thank you, sir. So I would like to personally thank you, sir, for encouraging us to follow the guts as a civil engineer. Besides the myth that a civil engineer has no scope, you enlightened us with your speech. So thank you for that, sir. So next, I would like to invite Dr. R. Kumuda, HOD of Civil Engineering Department. She will be releasing the department magazine Civilian Chronicle 2020-2021.
Yeah, thank you, Ashia, for the opportunity. So as I said, so this is the first magazine of the department since the inception. So I'm very much happy to release. I'd like to appreciate and congratulate all the office bearers of the academic year 2021. So we have taken up this initiative, especially with the help of the faculty coordinators, Mr. Kalaivanan and Mr. Harishwaran, and for your tremendous support in providing the articles to this particular magazine. And so now we are here today to release this particular magazine, so I'm very much happy. Yes, you can show the contents. So editorial board, especially I'd like to thank the editorial board. So we have faculty coordinators, Mr. Kalaivanan, Mr. Harishwaran, and also Mr. Abhishek Murali of third year from the last year, and Ms. Darshini, Ms. Monisha, and Ms. Arshia. So they have contributed for this release. So my congratulations to them and my best wishes to them. So, and I wish this release of magazine, this venture, has to continue in future also. So every year we are planning to release this magazine. And also, I request the students to contribute more for this magazine by in way of giving articles, okay, so innovations, whatever it is. So please contribute for this so that I will release this magazine every year.
Thank you, ma'am. I invite Mr. S. Harishwaran, Assistant Professor in Department of Civil Engineering, to introduce the office bearers for the academic year 2021 and 2022.
Yeah, thank you, Ms. Arshia. I welcome you all for the Civil Engineering Association inauguration, followed by expert lecture. I hope today's expert lecture on civil engineering and entrepreneurship by Dr. S. Sai Babu was strengthen the students' confidence to face the competitive world by sharing his own experience. Thank you very much for delivering the session by accept our invitation, sir. So Now it's my immense pleasure to introduce the Civil Engineering Association office bearers for the academic year 2021-22 here. So I would like to introduce our office bearer to share the screen. Mr. Abhishek Murali from final year civil engineering will act as a president. Monisha from final year civil engineering will act as a treasurer. Ms. Arshia, third year civil engineering, will act as a general secretary. Ms. Amaravati from second year civil engineering will act as a joint secretary. Harshavardhani from third year civil engineering, Janisha from third year civil engineering, Janani from third year civil engineering, Lalit Kumar from third year civil engineering will act as a senior executive member. Mr. Avinash, Mr. Puviyarasu, Mr. Tika Shivakumar, and Sri Laka from second year civil engineering will act as a joint executive member. Thank you all. It's over to you, Ms. Arshia.
Thank you, sir. Now I call upon Mr. Abhishek Murali, President of Civil Engineering Association, to deliver the word of thanks.
As the saying goes, everything that begins well ends well too. And our CEA inaugural is no different. A warm good afternoon to our chief guest, head of the department, faculty members, and my dear friends. It's an emotional moment for me personally, and I find it so fitting to be here proposing the vote of thanks for today's inaugural. I, on behalf of Civil Engineering Association, first of all extend my most sincere thanks to the institution for giving us this excellent opportunity. I extend my gratitude to our honorable chief guest, Dr. S. Sai Babu, for finding time amidst his busy schedule to grace this event. Thank you, sir, for your thought-provoking and motivational session. A special thanks to our HOD, Dr. R. Kumada, for providing immense support to make the inaugural a success. I extend my gratitude to our faculty in charge of CEA, Mr. R. Kalaivanan and Mr. S. Harishwaran, for arranging this event. Last but not the least, all this would have been in vain if not for your support by showing up for this inaugural in large numbers. Thank you, my dear friends. Finally, I depart expressing my gratitude to one and all involved in this. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you, Abhishek. So let's end the session with the national anthem.
Thank you very much. I'll take a leave, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Congratulations to all the new office bearers. Thank you very much. We'll meet again. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.